Hey everybody, Dr. Kerfasa here. In this video, we're gonna continue our discussion on supplements, and we are talking today about proprietary blends versus standardizations. Now, this often, when we apply this approach, we often are looking at herbal formulas or herbs that are incorporated into specific supplements for specific reasons. So again, today we're talking about proprietary blends for standardization. Now, proprietary blends are very commonly seen in over-the-counter supplements. And this is because they are, again, simply and can be cheaply manufactured. Again, I'm not saying all supplements over-the-counter are cheap or cheaply manufactured, etc., that they don't have good qualities. Many of them do. But we want to look at a few specific things when we're analyzing them. Now, proprietary blends can be good, but they can also be bad. Now, I have a sample supplement here, and it is of good quality, and we actually do have a proprietary blend in this supplement, but inside of the proprietary blend, we have standardization of each nutrient and each herb, etc. Now, proprietary blends, what often you see when they are of bad quality is, well, they have taken a number of nutrients, 5, 10, 20, whatever it might be, and they throw this into a proprietary blend. Now, these proprietary blends, often the problem is that when they are not, first of all, standardized, and in general, oftentimes you might not know what of how much you're getting of each nutrient. So if you have five herbs in a proprietary blend, and it might be cheaply manufactured, though, you might be getting 90% of one of those herbs, and the remaining 10% make up the rest of the four. So obviously you don't want that. You wanna, if you have a supplement and it's an herbal formula and it's a proprietary blend, but it has a specific function that you're taking for that, you wanna make sure that you're getting all of those nutrients and the herbs within that formula in balanced amounts, or in amounts that are gonna be beneficial for what you're taking it for. So this is very important, because, you know, we can have, there's a number of proprietary blends out there. So again, as they can be used for negative effects, or not negative effects, more like they are not as effective because they're just throwing a bunch of stuff into a pot and not actually telling you what's in them. Proprietary blends are also sometimes protected. So some companies can use proprietary blends because they have found a great formula that works very effective, and so they wanna make it a proprietary blend. They're not gonna tell people what's in the blend or how much of each nutrient is in the blend. So this can go both ways, and this is important to remember about proprietary blends. But more often than not, there's a number of herbs that can be in a proprietary blend, and you don't know how much is of each herb is in that blend. So again, this is important because when we're looking at herbs and other supplements, we want to make sure that we are actually getting the part of the herb that is active in the body, the part of the herb that has been undergone in clinical trials and research and known to be effective. So this breaks us down to standardization as well. Now, when we're looking at herbal formulas in general, we want to look and make sure that whatever part of this herb that we're taking, we want to make sure that is active, because you're taking it for a reason. You don't want to just pay money for a supplement and be like, well, they took the wrong part of the plant or the herb. So we want to look at, is it coming from the flower? Is it coming from the stems? Is it coming from the leaves? Is it coming from the roots? Are they taking the entire plant? This is important, as some plants have active constituents in certain parts that we've researched, while there's so many plants and herbs out there that we've only learned 1% of the actual active compounds in there. So there's many different active ingredients in a number of herbs. But some plants, you can take the entire herb and it can be effective. So all these things, again, need to be taken into account. And again, I don't recommend anybody just taking a blanket herb, blanket supplement, blanket anything, because it's on a case-by-case basis. It's on a patient-by-patient basis. Some patients respond very well to some herbs and supplements. Some patients do not. So again, this needs to be taken into account based on their own biological variability or biochemical individuality is what the term is. So when we're looking at standardization, we want to make sure, again, this is often a little bit of a better marker. So we're looking at this supplement here today, and we see it's a proprietary blend, but it has standardization of each nutrient. So we have a bioflavonoid complex, we have a green coffee bean extract, which is standardized to 45% chlorogenic acid. Again, the standardization means that we have taken the specific part of this plant and we have extracted it, and you're getting this much into that supplement, in the supplement. You're getting that amount in the supplement. Now again, this is what is in the supplement. Now, are you absorbing it? Are you digesting it? Or are you incorporating it into your body, into your cellular system? Again, this is all based on the previous video that we made, that we always want to look at the quality, the quantity, and whether you're digesting, absorbing. Again, this varies from person to person. It's very individualized. So that's why you can have, you know, a supplement that five people react to that's on the over the counter, and five people then don't. Same reason why you can have a prescription medication and one person might not react to it, but another person might metabolize it very quickly and react highly to it. And then you have a lot of people in the middle who react to it in a general fashion. And so that's the dosage that they often give people. So again, this is crucial to understand when you're looking at herbs and herbal formulas, specifically on the shelves. So you can have proprietary blends. Sometimes they can be beneficial, sometimes they cannot be. And sometimes, more often than not, on the shelf, they can be just easy to manufacture, but you wanna know what's in that supplement. So standardization, as we're saying, is very good to look at. I hope this video helped you. Dr. Anthony Fafasi, have a great day.